you to show me. Hush your lips, stop your
and Arsenal have the breakthrough. The angle brilliantly.
Manchester City lead.
Kirby onto a left foot, plants it brilliantly.
Oh, it's in.
Oh, what a goal. To herald the fact that they are the champions. A clash in store for you this afternoon. Live on Facebook, it's free scoring Arsenal versus Super League debutants West Ham United. This one will no doubt have drama. Do join us this Sunday live on Facebook for Arsenal and West Ham United. Yeah, a bit too early for the table to take some major shape, but critics and pundits alike will no doubt be staring at that goal difference column. Just two games in, and it's a plus 12 advantage for Arsenal, who sit top of this Women's Super League. West Ham, they currently occupy seventh spot, having played out a 0-0 draw with Reading during the week, having played one less fixture than 10 other teams in the division. For Matt Beard's side, this season will be about consolidation and ultimate safety. Arsenal, though, are on the hunt for silverware. Onto the teams, and Arsenal make two changes to the lineup that destroyed Yeovil on Wednesday evening. Both Beth Mead and Jessica Samuelson drop to the bench. Leah Williamson slots into the back line to partner Louise Quinn after recovering from a calf injury. Katie McCabe joins the attacking three. Jordan Nobbs retains her place in midfield, and after a commanding display midweek, she will look to bring her rich vein of form into this one. Ahead of this time, Matt Beard has made three changes to the lineup that fought hard for a point against Reading during the week. Lucien Rijkaard and Esme de Graaf both drop to the bench. Rhea Percival and Kate Longhurst jump into the lineup. Leah Kiernan also comes in place of Brooke Hendricks, who doesn't even make the bench. Look out for Jillie Flaherty. She won five major honours in a long-term stint at Arsenal, a real legend there before she moved on to Chelsea, winning the Women's Super League twice.
And Arsenal!
Yeah, conditions overcast, cloudy with just a hint of rain in the air this afternoon in Boreham Wood. Perfect, some would say, for a game of football. It's Arsenal versus West Ham United. Do join us, you're very welcome. On Facebook Live, solid at the back, lethal in front of goal. The Gunners are certainly going for goal this afternoon against a new team in West Ham United, but a team led by a manager who has won this competition before twice with Liverpool, Matt Beard. He has experience in the Women's Super League. Of course, they met 35 days ago in the Continental Cup, Arsenal beating West Ham United by 3-1 in mid-August in the Continental Cup. But a debut season in the WSL for West Ham United, who were really highly commended after that 0-0 draw against Reading midweek. But Arsenal come here in a rich vein of form. 12 goals in the last two games, 24 goals in all four fixtures they've played, two in the Cup and two in this Women's Super League. Just one goal conceded. That back line solid as anything, but going forward, Arsenal very, very scary indeed, especially with the likes of Beth Mead on the bench. They can do some serious damage. Arsenal just lining up for a customary pre-match photo, whereas West Ham United running through some final drills. This one's certainly going to be a fascinating encounter. plenty of goals expected, plenty of other fixtures going on this afternoon in the WSL. There's a near full program, I do believe, as a few teams take to the fields. Everton taking on Chelsea, Manchester City hosting Bristol City, and Reading hosting Birmingham City, flying high, second in the league. Birmingham City with two wins out of their opening two fixtures. And we are awaiting kickoff here at Boreham Wood. A good crowd for early autumn. Again, chilly, somewhat overcast. And here we go, the team switching sides. Whatever competitive advantage you can get, make it count. As both teams switch sides, so Arsenal will be attacking to my left, and we'll be playing from right to left in this first half in those red shirts, white shorts, white socks, the traditional Arsenal home kit, and West Ham United in their change of blue with yellow socks, and both keepers in green today. We love a bit of tradition. So here we go for match day three of the FA Women's Super League. And perfect to Arsenal. Look to extend their 100% record at the top of the Women's Super League. Conceded none, scored 12. Certainly expecting some goals this afternoon in Boreham Wood. And we are off in this match day three of the FA Women's Super League. As Arsenal welcome West Ham United to Boreham Wood. An early touch on the ball for Leah Williamson. She's been struggling with a minor calf complaint. There were question marks over whether she would be included in this squad. Good work by Kim Little. Sends the ball into the box and an early chance for Vivian Medema. Couldn't quite get any purchase on the header, and it heads behind for a goal kick. But back to Leah Williamson. Question marks over her fitness, but she's made the first team squad and she starts this afternoon for Joe Montemurro. Brilliant work by Kim Little down the right hand side, shimmying past the fullback, checking back. And a ball with the right foot, and Medema just couldn't get any purchase on it as she was harried by Chilly Flaherty. And West Ham United on the attack at the other end with Alicia Lehman. It's punched out by Peyron Magnin and claimed at the second attempt. An open start to this one. The free kick given against West Ham United. Rhea Percival with a bit of aggression as Jordan Nobbs tried to get onto the ball. Put it back over the halfway line. Arsenal looking to regain a bit of composure. Free kick to the Gunners though. West Ham coming in with a bit of aggression. I've been asked by Herman, where is the Dutch stormer, De Graaf? Two goals last week, Herman, but she makes the bench today for West Ham United. West Ham just trying to bring the tempo down, suck the life out of the game for Arsenal and build from the front. Shane Allen saying, good luck, West Ham. I'll be watching and cheering. Thank you very much for joining us, Shane. Whereas Cheryl Rogers is firmly in for the Gummers. Here comes Maduma down the middle of the pitch. Checks onto her right, back onto her left, and back onto her right. Can't quite get the shot away. You've got to give credit to the West Ham back line there for some decent defending. It's back by Williamson to her goalkeeper, who will be put under pressure by Jane Ross. But Payro Magnin manages to get the ball away, and West Ham United have the ball in a dangerous position. There's a ferocious battle going on down there between Bloodworth and Julius Simic. Arsenal managed to get the ball away, but West Ham United can pick up possession once again. Here come Arsenal now. Madema with the ball down the middle, looking for Job and Jordan Nobbs. She won't latch onto it, and it'll be played back towards Becky Spencer in the West Ham United goal. And they will build from the back once again. Once again, Matt Beard, the West Ham United manager, comes into this clash and into this club. A very, very experienced coach at this level. He's won the Women's Super League twice in 2013 and 14 with Liverpool. He took Liverpool into Europe, into the Champions League. Coached at Charlton, Millwall Lionesses, Chelsea, Liverpool. So he really is the man for the job, bringing West Ham United into their debut season in the Women's Super League. Ball played forward by Becky Spencer. And that will be picked up by Rhea Percival for the throw-in. Here comes Madema, edge of the area, drives a shot in. And there's claims of a touch. It looked like an excellent save by Becky Spencer that managed to get her fingertips onto it. Madema just at the edge of the area, on the edge of the D, slamming home a right-footed shot after some poor possession, possession turnover by West Ham United. Arsenal managing to pick it up, win it. And Madema with the shot, striking it away. And just palmed behind by Becky Spencer. So we have our first corner of the game. And it'll be played out towards the halfway line. Poor again by Arsenal. Arsenal trying to build through Katie McCabe down that left-hand flank. Emma Mitchell sending the ball in field. There is a foul. And a quick free kick taken by Leah Welty. She's managed to find a play on the right-hand side. And Arsenal just changing things around. West Ham with a very solid intent, looking to keep things tight. Of course, against the division's best forward line. Arsenal going close early on, and there will be a ball played in early doors, and McCabe can't quite get onto it with Spencer lurking. And West Ham United will build again with Percival. Needs to be careful, she's got Katie McCabe lurking with her. McCabe wins that duel. I think Percival's getting a lot of questions asked of her. She didn't look too pleased at her colleagues, who were questioning where she was going with that ball as McCabe closed her down. Arsenal closing West Ham United down once again, and it's Emma Mitchell on this near side who will take the throw, and it's just brought forward and into the middle for Jordan Nobbs. She will look to control play, squares it now for Kim Little, the Arsenal captain.
All right.
something to the middle. But Arsenal manager Joe Montemurro called for focus in his programme notes earlier. A very, very good read, in fact, with Joe Montemurro talking about how West Ham United were very, very well organised and that Arsenal will need to control from the start. Whilst they've had opportunities, West Ham United look very, very strong in defence. Again, a good battle there by the West Ham midfield, looking to gain ground and squeeze Arsenal. Percival to quick round the corner. Lehmann's sent the ball into the middle. There's a header and there's the opening goal. And West Ham United take the lead. It's Katie Longhurst with the goal. A fabulous header and a quick incisive breakaway from West Ham United. Alicia Lehmann with fabulous work down the right hand side once again.
For West Ham United, number 12, Kate Longhurst.
Quick bit of play as West Ham converted defence into attack, and Lehmann with some brilliant play down the right hand side holds off the fullback, sends a great ball into the middle, and Kate Longhurst fires West Ham United into an unlikely lead here at Boreham Wood. Arsenal with plenty to do. As we approach the 10th minute, it's Arsenal 0, West Ham United 1. I'm looking to now just building this lead as they go down the right hand side. Lehmann, the potent outlet, driving towards goal, fires the ball in. It'll be hastily cleared away. No, as far as Lehmann and Pauline Payer of Magnan, who has only conceded one goal this season, was keen not to make it two. Thanks to Shane for joining us this afternoon, saying getting their goal, come on you Irons. It was a fabulous goal by Longhurst, but Arsenal really riding their luck. And Pauline Peyre-Magnan having to be very, very alert to get onto that one. Here comes Mademo with the shot, and it's just touched behind the line by Becky Spencer. Great bit of work by Kim Ross. Dinks the ball over the top of the bat line, chested down by Mademo into the area, fires the shot behind. And West Ham United really living a bit dangerously there, but Arsenal with their second corner of the game. McKay with the left-footed ball into the middle, header, and it's deflected behind. And Arsenal grab the equaliser. And it's a great bit of work by Daniel van den Donk, standing in front of the keeper, deflecting the ball behind after the initial header. And just 2 minutes after their opener, and Arsenal have found an equaliser.
The Arsenal goal scorer, number 7, Daniel van den Donk.
Daniel van den Donk restoring parity. Arsenal back on level terms. It only took 2 minutes. Plenty of love coming in for the Arsenal players. Daisy Stoker very happy. Max very happy. Ashlyn very happy. As is Art and Nathan saying, good response, Arsenal. And here they come once again down the right-hand flank. And the ball will just be deflected out. Nemish very, very happy that Daniel van den Donk grabbed the goal, as are we. this one a ferocious contest early on. Again, Joe Montemurro in his programme notes calling for calm, calling for control, and Arsenal to be very, very organised. They slipped at the first hurdle, conceding that goal to Katie Longhurst, a fabulous header. But Daniel van den Donk just 2 minutes later with the equaliser, and the Gunners are back on level terms. Here come West Ham United with Lehmann charging down the middle. It'll be claimed by Peyre Magnum. Arsenal building down the right hand side now, searching for another goal. Two in quick succession will be very, very good just to calm things down. Here comes Percival. She can't keep the ball in the middle. Thanks to Nicola saying, I think West Ham will be a strong addition to the league. Some amazing signings, and I say that as a Gooner. Thank you very much for joining us, Nicola. Williamson bringing the ball into the opposition half. Nobbs looking for the 1-2. Percival will try and send it away and send Alicia Lehmann down that right hand side. She really is a live wire for West Ham United. Poor from her just there. Jane Ross in a bit of space. That one for Mitchell. Or so minutes in, it seems that Arsenal have grabbed control of this time. The ball spread wide and then towards van den Donk. There is Jordan Nobbs looking for Medema. There is a offside flag raised against Dominic Bloodworth, who rushed up from full back position. Spencer just sending the West Ham squad upfield, and that free kick bounces all the way out and out for a throw-in. And that's poor from the Arsenal goalkeeper. West Ham United in a fabulous save. Lehmann can get onto the rebound. No, she can't. And it's deflected in once again. Katie Longhurst has two. And so do West Ham United. Poor defending by Arsenal. Their coach called for control. He wanted them to be organised. And they were far from organised as West Ham United fired their second goal in.
Goal scorer for West Ham United, number 12, Kate Longhurst.
Poor from Bloodworth. And the ball picked up, shot fired away. You expected Lehmann to tuck it away. A fabulous tackle there by Louise Quinn. But Longhurst, who's got the shooting balls, shooting boots on, managed to fire the ball into the back of the net. Peyre Magnin with the long ball forward. Rhea Percival picks the ball up on the halfway line. Percival into the middle. Leanne Kiernan trying to win the ball, who had the initial shot that was saved by Pauline Peyre Magnin. Leanne Kiernan coming in to the side this afternoon. Spencer tries to get some height on the kick. A lot of question about Sari van Veenendaal. Of course, Arsenal's number one last season. She is on the bench this afternoon. As Pauline Perra-Magnin, who's been in good form, conceded one goal in her last four games. Of course, conceded nothing up until today in the Women's Super League. She retained her place in goal. But hasn't been fortunate today as Kate Longhurst has grabbed two goals to put West Ham United league debutants ahead here at Meadow Park. It is back with Perra-Magnin. She's under pressure from Leanne Kiernan. Ball headed back towards the Arsenal area, and they really are under pressure. The referee gives no foul as things are coming together. A lot of questions about Arsenal's number 11 today, Vivian Miedema. And I'll tell you what, I'd open it up on Facebook and I'd love for you to tell me how to pronounce a word, because I've got five or six different pronunciations in front of me and I'd appreciate them all. Thank you very much for your comments so far this afternoon. We are approaching the 20th minute in the game. Arsenal currently 2-1 down to league debutants West Ham United. West Ham can't turn play over. Here is Kim Little. Takes her time, sends the ball forward into the box for Jordan Nobbs. She'll have to battle for it. And West Ham United will look to send it away with Julius Simic. Miedema, that's what I'm getting from Max. John Schering, Miedema. Thank you very much to everyone getting involved. I'll go for Miedema. Got a bit of a pause. There's a West Ham United player currently receiving some treatment. Bit of treatment being administered there to Claire Rafferty. West Ham United with a... It's Kate Longhurst who's getting the treatment. Longhurst has been absolutely fantastic for West Ham United so far. As they take a lead into the 21st minute. Arsenal with the throw in. Ball sent over the top. And here comes Miedema inside the box. Checks back onto her right. And Kim Little can't quite get the shot away. She's driven back towards her own goal. You've got to give credit there to Vasali and Lehmann. But the ball fired back in towards the West Ham United goal. Arsenal looking to build from the back now. Mitchell Leo Walty's just taken up a deeper lying role in that midfield, loses possession, and here come West Ham United again, but it's well dealt with by Williamson. Little takes control on the edge of her own area. So hopeful ball played forward by Dominique Blodworth. She was looking for the run of Casey McCabe. And Arsenal unusually behind here at home to West Ham United. And they'll continue to build down the right-hand flank with Van den Dock, the Arsenal goalscorer who grabbed the equaliser in 11 minutes. It falls for Maderma. She can't quite fire the shot away. West Ham United will get it away. The referee, in fact, has given a free kick to the visitors. It's taken quickly. West Ham looking just to bring the tempo of the game down as Arsenal frantically tried to grab an equaliser for the second time. But here they come down the left-hand side. Claire Rafferty can't quite keep the ball in play. And the hosts will have a throw-in. Poor control there by Jenny Flaherty, but possession regained in the midfield, and West Ham United will look to build again with Julia Simic. She plays it out wide for Lehmann. Lehmann continuing to battle for the ball with her Arsenal counterparts, a ferocious competitor down that right hand flank. She has been fantastic for Matt Beard's side this afternoon. Arsenal now looking to be a bit more patient, build up from the back. Still plenty of time left in this one to grab an equaliser, maybe a winner, maybe a couple of winners. Plenty of goals left in this side, including Beth Mead on the bench as well. And they come down the right-hand side though, ball swung into the middle, and Becky Spencer had to be alert there as Jordan Nobbs just lifted the ball in towards Maderma. Ball just hastily played out towards Rhea Percival. She won't get onto it. Arsenal will win the throw-in once again, and this is another opportunity for them to test the West Ham back line. They're putting it under stress, especially Vivian Maderma. Claims for a free kick, nothing given there. West Ham will break now with Simic. And Rafferty will take over down the left-hand side. Just keep it in, West Ham. Ball lifted forward towards Jane Ross. Leah Williamson up there with her. Ross wins that battle, wins another battle, and retains possession. Still Jane Ross on the ball for West Ham United. Leanne Kiernan can't quite retain possession, but this is good from West Ham United. Putting Arsenal under some serious pressure and bossing the game in midfield. Percival, left-footed ball forward. Seems like Brianna Vassalli has joined the party on the near side here. Freaky. taken, and the header's deflected into the arms of Pauline Peyre-Magnin. West Ham pressing Arsenal very, very firmly. Wilty manages to get the ball out wide for Leah Williamson. She sends it forward in towards Jordan Nobbs. The fullback overlapping. In fact, it's Daniel van den Donk who was overlapping, but West Ham United managing to harry the ball away towards the halfway line. The Danes drop deep to try and win possession back. It's one back in the midfield, and after a strong challenge by Emma Mitchell on Kiernan. Into midfield, here is Nobbs. Sends the ball out wide once again. It'll be floated into the middle, and Becky Spencer just opting to leave it with Rhea Percival there with her. Good decision by the West Ham United goalkeeper. Quick free kick taken by Gilly Flaherty. It's won by Jane Ross after it looked like West Ham United would lose possession in that Arsenal midfield, but here they come once again. And just a quick score from elsewhere. Manchester City are 1-0 behind in their pursuit. We will have a highlights package from the other fixtures at half time, so do join us at half time and stick with us at half time as we will take you around the grounds around the country this match day 3 of the FA Women's Super League. Ball back with Peyre-Magnin. Mitchell squaring the ball in. West Ham harrying and pressing Arsenal very, very hard indeed, looking for mistakes, and they've drawn two out of them already. One of them West Ham capitalised on. Williamson looking for options, finds Louise Quinn. It's a left footed ball scoop forward, and the offside flag is raised on the Arsenal skipper Kim Little. And we do have a break in play now because Kate Longhurst is down again. She's been down injured before. She received a bit of treatment from the West Ham United medical team. Deemed fit to continue. Longhurst on the ground once again. We'll wait to see what happens following her treatment by the West Ham United physio, who is on the field at the moment. Longhurst still receiving treatment. An opportunity for a rest and a drink, but we'll have a look at the goals. Of course, West Ham United taking the lead. Some brilliant work down the right hand side by Alicia Lehmann, keeping the ball in play and finding a wonderful ball And an even better header from Kate Longhurst to open in the scoring for West Ham United. And we are back underway. Longhurst fit to continue once again. She's received treatment. And West Ham United have the throw-in. Rafferty caught in possession there. She's conceded the throw-in. Arsenal will look to Bill once again with Van den Donk. And that's poor defending by West Ham United. Arsenal capitalised. Jordan Nobbs slides it in. Well, she won't. And it's a good save by Becky Spencer. Low down to her left. And Jordan Nobbs missing when it was easier to score. But Arsenal with a fabulous chance there to grab an equaliser. Here come the hosts once again down the right hand flank. There is Jordan Nobbs looking for a pass in field. And once again, West Ham just looking to squeeze Arsenal. Not give them space to operate. Mitchell sends the ball over the top. Percival is there. Lehman is there with Mitchell. And West Ham United retain possession now. Up in the midfield by Longhurst. She'll feed it back to the goalkeeper, Becky Spencer. It was a fabulous save by Spencer to deny Jordan Nobbs. That would have made it 2-2. Van den Donk struggles there, but let's have a Mitchell to take the throw in for Arsenal. We trail here with 10 or so minutes to go before half time. It's played straight down the line by Mitchell to Van den Donk. She overtakes Rhea Percival into the box, Van den Donk, and it's well picked up. And left. And there's an offside flag there. The West Ham United just pausing. And a lack of concentration enabling Arsenal to thread the ball through. Let's have a look at that chance for Jordan Nobbs. Poor defending by West Ham United. Nobbs just picks up and you expect her to score there. You really, really do. A fabulous save by Becky Spencer coming out, sprawling and parrying the ball to safety. But I would have put my house on that. Here comes Lehman and she's clashed with Peyro Magnin. Lehman's back up. Percival battling for the ball. And West Ham United really causing Arsenal some issues. Free kick to the host now. And the referee calls time on another battle. Leah Williamson. Ball played out wide. It's cleared away by Claire Rafferty. Lauren Senior saying, pull it together, Gunners. Lauren, you're spot on there. Haven't been at their best today, Arsenal. Bit of complacency edging into their game. Plenty of energy from West Ham United. Plenty of pressure, plenty of strength. They have looked absolutely top-notch today. But here come Arsenal with Kim Little. Onside Little, checks onto her right. Still Kim Little, and doesn't fire the shot away. It's still in play though, and the resulting shot heads behind. A great ball played down the middle, completely missed by Jilly Flaherty. Little with so many opportunities to score, far too many opportunities, far too much time in fact. And she couldn't get the shot away. West Ham United will head into this break very, very happy with their first half endeavours. Ball headed on by Longhurst, who's been absolutely excellent in attack for the visitors this afternoon. We'll check back to Erin Simon, USA international. Jane Ross, she loses possession and Arsenal will push forward once again. Simon is there, commits with the sliding challenge. Picked up once again by Julius Simic. Here come the visitors once again with Vasali. Percival has it in the opposition half, tries to dink the ball forward. Van den Donk will recover for Arsenal. They'll take their time as they try to bring it forward with Williamson down the right hand flank. Dale is enjoying the action, saying wonderful. Thank you very much for joining us this Sunday lunchtime, Dale. That's a fabulous ball played out wide to Daniel Van den Donk. 25 or so yards out. She leaves it for Kim Little. Here comes Little, quick exchange with Maduma. Little tries to square the ball across. It's deflected behind by Becky Spencer. Once again, West Ham defending very, very well. A great bit of play there. Van den Donk, Kim Little involved, and Little just with acceleration to just burn past a couple of players, burn past Rhea Percival. There's a combination of Spencer and Flaherty on the line to deflect that ball behind. And Arsenal with their third corner of the game. And it looks like it's deflected in. In fact, it is. Arsenal score, and it's Daniel Van den Donk with the goal. She's being awarded it by her colleagues. And the ball just being pinballed around the area. And plenty of West Ham United players just switching off. But Arsenal managed to get back onto level terms in this game. It was pushed towards goal by Louise Quinn, deflected off of two or three West Ham United players, and then just knocked in by Daniel Van den Donk. Two for Longhurst for West Ham United, two for Van den Donk, and we are at 2-2 right now. Brilliant spectacle this has been. Lauren Senior very, very happy with that goal. So is John Schürrling. Ashling has said, let's go, you Gunners. They've managed to get themselves back on level terms with West Ham United. Very much an unspectacular goal and a messy goal, if you like, from Arsenal. But here comes Van den Donk once again on the hat-trick. Van den Donk, no time to shoot. She is brought down and there will be a free kick for Arsenal in a very, very dangerous position. Challenged by Erin Simon there, and what an opportunity this is for Arsenal. Plenty standing over it. Max has said time for a Daniel hat-trick. There is plenty of time for a Daniel hat-trick, Max. Looks like it's me, Dominic Bloodworth, to take this one. Bloodworth steps up, and it's saved by the keeper, parried away, and managed. Well, West Ham have managed to claw it away. Spencer making the initial save. And it was awkward for the goalkeeper. A short run up from Bloodworth. Bloodworth once again firing it towards goal. Spencer with the save. And the congregation of players around Becky Spencer couldn't have made it easy for her. This one has certainly been full of action as we approach the break. Arsenal pushing for another goal before the break. We're into the final minute here in Boreham Wood. Mitchell will send it back to Wildy to resume Arsenal's charge. West Ham United a little bit shaken. Van den Donk takes possession and takes control. It's fought by Nobbs on towards Maduma, who can't quite get the purchase on the shot. It was a left-footed effort and easy for Spencer in the end. But another good chance for Arsenal goes begging. A brilliant bit of work by Jordan Nobbs. Finds Maduma. She just tries on the move to get the shot away. Spencer keeps West Ham United in it.
Two minutes of added time awarded by the fourth official
at the end of this one. Presumably, the treatment to Kate Longhurst gives us that 2 minutes. And no doubt it'll be 2 minutes where Arsenal will look to push to take a lead into this break. Mitchell. Wildsey and Louise Quinn just exchanging passes. It's out down the right-hand flank now. Back with Leo Valti, who's been essential in that Arsenal midfield, controlling everything and just trying to push West Ham United away. But this is brilliant from Kim Little down the left-hand side, and Rhea Percival gets there, manages to edge Little off of the ball and will win the throw-in for her side. Sent across the halfway line. It's picked up by Quinn. Quinn in towards Leah Williamson. And Arsenal will pick it up in the midfield once again. There's Maduma. And there we have it. Half time here. A fabulous, fabulous half of football. A great exhibition for the Women's Super League, an example of the Women's Super League. And West Ham United really giving as good as they get. Yeah, taking the lead through Kate Longhurst. 9 minutes in, Daniel Van den Donk levelled things up. 2 minutes later, Kate Longhurst fired West Ham United back into the league, and then a scruffy goal for Arsenal. And replying with a scruffy goal for Arsenal. to make it 2-2. Arsenal with a couple of chances to take a lead into the break. Daniel Bloodworth with potentially the best, forcing a good save out of Becky Spencer, and the West Ham United goal has been very, very busy indeed. Half time here though, it's Arsenal 2, West Ham United 2, and we will go over and grab some highlights from the rest of the WSL.
After a thumping 5-0 win against Liverpool on opening day, Arsenal travelled to the West Country to take on Yeovil. Once again, they were in the mood for goals. There was a stroke of good fortune about the opener here. Good work from Jordan Nobbs, but her shot wouldn't have gone in were it not for the deflection of Hannah Short. The Gunners doubled their lead when Beth Mead bundled in from close range following a goal-mouth scramble.
But Arsenal weren't rattled as they managed to grab an equaliser just moments later. Yeah. Daniel van den Donk with her first goal of the season. Wouldn't be her last of today. West Ham United regaining the lead after some very, very sloppy defending by Arsenal. The ball picked up in the midfield. It was a fantastic shot by Leanne Kiernan, and the second rebound tucked home by Kate Longhurst for her second of the game. Arsenal going close there. Jordan Nobbs really should have scored from that opportunity. A great save by Spencer, but there's the equaliser. And after a header from Quinn, it's Van den Donk with her second of the game and second of the new Women's Super League season. That brought us to the halftime score of Arsenal 2, West Ham United 2. Yeah, taking a look at some of the other action in the FA Women's Super League. A few other games that are occurring today. Five in total in the competition. Brighton and Hove Albion, the other new addition to this year's Women's Super League, managed by Hope Powell, went down by 1-0. A late Rinsola Babangida goal won it for Liverpool in the 85th minute at Crawley. And a big goal after the resignation of Neil Redfern. He has left Liverpool women, but they have managed to pick up a win after a poor start to their campaign. Half time elsewhere to Everton 0, Chelsea 0. Manchester City 0, Bristol City 1. And a big goal from Kerdike up in Manchester. It's half time there. And Reading 0, Birmingham City 1. Reading with a very, very good start to the season. A brilliant finish to last season. Sargent with the goal for Birmingham City women. That has put them ahead, and they are ahead at half time. And as it stands, Birmingham City top of the Women's Super League One. Plenty of time to go. We've got the whole of the second half en route on Facebook. Just into the FA Women's Championship. Three fixtures at 12 o'clock. Lewis taking on Leicester City. London Bees host Manchester United. And Millwall Lionesses entertain Crystal Palace in a South London derby. Tottenham versus Sheffield United. That one called off this morning due to a waterlogged pitch. That one in the Women's Championship. But we are here for some Super League action. It's Arsenal 2, West Ham United 2. Thank you very much for joining us on Facebook Live this afternoon as we await the start of the second half. Thank you very much to Edwin Knight for your kind comments. Glad he has the live feed. Thank you very much for joining us, Edwin, this afternoon as we await kickoff in this one. Paul Howard, the referee, has put the ball on the spot. West Ham in a huddle to our right. I've just broken that, and we will have kickoff for this second half at Boreham Wood. And the visitors get us underway for the second 45. Arsenal with loads of work to do, but West Ham United will be very, very happy with their first half showing. Two goals against a mean Arsenal defence. And Arsenal will kick from left to right in those red shirts with the white trim, white shorts and white socks. West Ham United in a change kit of blue with claret trim, blue shorts once again with that claret trim, and yellow socks. It's away by Percival, picked up by Lehman, and into the middle once again. Arsenal driving forward once again. And the shot from Jordan Nobbs just scooped over for our first opportunity of the second half. Lauren looking for a big performance for her Arsenal side. Come on, Gunners, pull it together and get all three. Nadia joins us from Taiwan. Thank you very much for joining us this afternoon. Spencer sends the ball forward. It'll be hooked forward, and West Ham United will look to build play. It's pinged over the top for Leanne Keane, and she's at the byline, tries to check onto her right foot, manages to get it onto her right boot. It's forward for Ross. Battled in the midfield by Kim Little. Arsenal win the free kick. Leo Walty. Quinn for Williamson. The long ball forward, that's wasteful by Arsenal. Spencer will let it run behind for the goal kick. No changes at half time for both sides, but plenty of experience, plenty of goals on the bench. Beth Mead available for Arsenal. Esme de Graaf for West Ham United. Here come Arsenal down the middle of the pitch. Jordan Nobbs leading the charge, finds McDermott on the right hand side. McDermott checks it back, looking for Kim Little, but a quick interception and it's back with McDermott on the right. Here is Bloodworth. Went very, very close late on in that first half with a late free kick. Quinn. Out wide for Mitchell. It's back with Quinn on the halfway line. Arsenal just penning West Ham United back in to their own half with some early second half pressure. Not. Finds McDermott down the right hand side again. Arsenal pinning West Ham into their own half and the Hammers having to deal with an enormous amount of pressure. It's back with Jordan Nobbs on the right hand flank. Rafferty will look to send the ball away, but West Ham United have the throw in. Little. McDermott will look to pick up the ball. Van den Donk in there as well. West Ham United looking just to get the ball as far away from their goal as possible, but Arsenal win the throw-in. It's back now with Leah Williamson. She squares it into the middle. Williamson brings the ball over the halfway line. It's a right-footed ball for Daniel Van den Donk. Two goals for her and two goals for Arsenal. Ball on the far side now. It's back with Mitchell. Arsenal very, very patient in their build-up play. And it's in towards Katie McCabe. She won't get any purchase on it. And West Ham United have another opportunity just to take pause, take stock of what's going on so far, because in the opening 5 minutes of this second period, it's been all Arsenal. Long ball up by Spencer. There's Longhurst, who fired West Ham ahead twice in this game. Lee Edwards is watching in Canada. Thank you for joining us. Ball scoot forward. Long looking for Jane Ross. It just opens up play with Rhea Percival. It's out wide to Lehman on the right-hand flank. Lehman will get the ball into the middle. Ross will send the ball towards goal. No purchase on it from Ross. And it's claimed by Pauline Peyre-Magnin. Long ball play forward, looking for the run of McDermott, but it's claimed by Spencer. And Arsenal looking just to play the channels once again. West Ham switching off at the back. Arsenal team scoring 26 goals now in their opening five games. Plus 12 goal advantage. And here is Longhurst. on the right-hand flank, brings Lehman into play. It's back with Longhurst, scoops the ball into the area, claimed by Pauline Peyre-Magnan. West Ham just making sure Arsenal know they are still there, they're still in this match. It's 2-2. And your next action, not live on Facebook, comes from the north of the country as Liverpool entertain Reading. That one next Sunday. It's a 2 o'clock kickoff. Do join us on Facebook for that. It certainly will be a spectacle. Reading currently one goal down at home to Birmingham City, though. They're the early front runners in the table. They've actually overtaken Arsenal as it stands. Bex has said, shout out to Stanway Rovers and Colchester, please. Loving the game. Thank you very much for joining us. Longhurst. It's forward by Rhea Percival, out towards the halfway line. Percival with the throw-in once again for West Ham United, immediately deflected back. We're here in Manchester City, have gone two goals behind. It's a big, big shock. And City now were two behind to Bristol City Ladies. Chelsea still 0-0. Rhea Percival has this throw-in for West Ham United. Forward in towards Lehman. And Arsenal win the throw. Here come Arsenal now. Nobbs just checking the ball in towards her captain, Kim Little. Little will look to spread the play. It's out wide now and well left for Van den Donk. Van den Donk's ball into the middle, headed away by Aaron Simon. It's back now with Leah Welty. He's moving into a more of an advanced role in this second half. Bloodworth, now Van den Donk, space to operate down that right-hand flank. Heads towards the byline, tries to chip the ball across. Rafferty will block. It's back with Bloodworth, drives it in. And a combination of Longhurst and Simon both blocking the ball, and it's deflected behind for the goal kick. Louise Watson in Winchester is watching the game this afternoon. Thanks for joining us. And Hev Osborne enjoying the live stream as well. Ball headed back by Little, be picked up by Medema. She chips it forward, or tries to dink it forward, in fact. I wonder if she was looking for the chip. It's Kim Little now who picks up the resulting ball in midfield. Hannah watching from University in Nottingham. Do hope you're enjoying this one. It's certainly been a spectacle. Arsenal 2, West Ham United 2. And here come the visitors once again through Julius Simic. Simic has to go backwards towards Rhea Percival. Sting forward down the right, looking for the run of Lehman. Cleared behind now by an Arsenal shirt, and West Ham United with the throw-in. Image. West Ham United lose possession. Arsenal look to turn it over and convert defence into attack. Here comes Van den Donk, scorer of those two goals that have kept them on level terms with their visitors. Bloodworth takes over down the right, checks it back onto her left and finds Van den Donk in space. West Ham United giving Danielle Van den Donk far too much space. She goes to ground and the resulting dink over, looking for the run from Bloodworth, is poor. Simon with the ball out for West Ham United. Rafferty. Back towards Erin Simon. It's a left-footed ball, ping forward. And Bloodworth will just guide the ball back towards her goalkeeper in plenty of space now. Pauline Pereira-Magna. Pereira-Magna with the left-footed ball forward. And it will be deflected behind for the throw in to Arsenal. Nicola Herdman looking for Beth Mead to come on at some point. We've had no changes so far in this game, but Arsenal will drive forward now with Kim Little. She comes under a bit of pressure in the midfield. Julia Simic offering a battle. Daniel Van den Donk will look to keep it in, but it's scooped out for a throw. And on the bench for Arsenal, Sari van Veenendaal, Jessica Samuelson, Lisa Evans, Beth Mead and Ava Kuykan as well. And Beth Mead would be the obvious change to make.
Go Jordan!
But here is Nobbs, ball deflected into the middle. Medema is there, tries to control it. Maybe just overdoes it. Jilly Flaherty there, deflecting it behind. But again, West Ham United's defence just switch off. Nobbs with the ball into the middle. Mademo with, again, too much time. Takes plenty of touches and slams the ball into the legs of Flaherty. And Arsenal have another corner. Their first of the second period. Their fourth overall. Driven in by Little, in towards the goalkeeper. And although Spencer claims it, I believe there is a foul given by Paul Howard, the referee. Paul Howard just having a word with the West Ham United goalkeeper. Arsenal retain possession following that West Ham United free kick. McCabe, who's been fairly quiet in that second half, but they were trying to play the quick 1-2. McCabe can't latch onto it, and it's cleared away for the throw-in, which the host will take. Joe Montemurro's side certainly showing more intent in this second half. They've really controlled the game. Here is Kim Little. She'll go on one of her runs, chips the ball in right-footed. Couldn't quite get any elevation on it, but it was cleared behind by Erin Simon. And Arsenal will have another corner and another opportunity to test Spencer in the West Ham United goal. It's played in long and across. Spencer gets a touch on it, but there's the hat-trick for Danielle Van den Donk. Arsenal grab their third. They've been behind twice, but they're ahead now. And the league leaders may just be staying there. Daniel Van den Donk with another hat-trick. And it was a corner ball played in from Little, headed down. And the bounce maybe just took it away from Spencer. Van den Donk with one chance. She got a second bite at it. And she's made it. Arsenal 3, West Ham United 2. plenty of time for West Ham United to get back into this. Sloppy defending. They've struggled with the set pieces that Arsenal have put in. There's certainly a lesson in women's football. Arsenal masters at this level, and West Ham United new to the Women's Super League, and maybe being taught somewhat of a lesson here. Percival send the ball long down the line. It'll be picked up by Leah Williamson. Dave Billington talking about how the pressure has told on West Ham United. Ev Osborne looking for a response for West Ham United. And Tina and Kieran both saying hat-trick. Well deserved. Daniel van der Donk. Nemesh looking for Arsenal to get the job done. One more could do it for them. But here come West Ham United with Lehmann, who's been a real presence down that right-hand flank, battling hard. Still Lehmann tries to send a shot towards goal. And that won't cause Pauline Peyre-Magnin any trouble at all. Arsenal pushing down the left-hand side. And Erin Simon has to be very, very careful there. She got Jordan Nobbs with her. Sam does very, very well. Turns defence into attack, and West Ham United could be on their way. Percival down the right-hand side. That's a not a nasty challenge, but firm. Leanne Kieran feeling the force there, and West Ham United with a free kick and an opportunity to keep Arsenal well out of their half, which is where Arsenal have been, resided for most of this second period. Flaherty with the long ball forward. She'll look for the runner Lehmann, and West Ham United have another throw-in. Vasali, Brianna Vasali, just sending the ball to Percival. Percival with the throw. Looks to the runner, Kiernan. Lehmann is there once again battling, tries to send the ball into the middle. West Ham United win their first corner of the game. And this, their first opportunity to test Pauline Peyre-Magnin from set pieces. Barry just with a comment talking about three goals from corners. It's poor, you can't do that against the top side. Spot on. Arsenal have been lethal from set pieces, but this West Ham's first opportunity to show their intent from theirs. Here comes the ball in towards Lehmann. No one can get any form of contact onto it. It's picked up by Simon, who swings the ball back into the middle. Dangerous, but well picked up by Pauline Peyre-Magnin. And Arsenal can break now with Nobbs down the left-hand side. She takes time, takes a touch, and will just calm things down for the Gunners. Van der Donk into the middle once again for Leah Walty. Williamson over the halfway line, dinks the ball forward. That's a interesting header that by Salmon. I'm sure looked to reach her goalkeeper, but has sent it back behind for another corner to Arsenal. And another opportunity for them to test Becky Spencer. When Arsenal get a corner, you just sense that there could be a mistake in that West Ham United back line. They have looked very, very shaky from set pieces, especially from corners, of which Arsenal have had five now. And it will be another one. Sent in from the right-hand side, and that one is well taken by Spencer. Arms up quickly and managed to grab the ball. And now West Ham United will be set away down the right-hand side. Lehmann, quick interchange with Longhurst. There is a clash there, but Emma Mitchell wins the ball. And we'll send Van den Donk down the left-hand side. Shouts to the offside flag. And it is given. And Spencer, under a bit of pressure there from Mademu, gets a touch, but Spencer manages to recover. And West Ham United living very, very dangerously. Here come Arsenal again with Kim Little. It's back towards Leo Walty. Walty just looking for options. Arsenal lead West Ham United by 3-2. And seem to have got themselves in a, not quite in a cruise control, but in a position of some comfort. I do believe Arsenal will be looking to make some changes. Beth Mead and Lisa Evans imminent for Joe Montemurro's men. I think he's looking to kill the game off, and here the substitutions will come.
Substitution for Arsenal, replacing number 16, Louise Quinn.
Louise Quinn being replaced.
Is number 17, Lisa Evans.
Katie McCabe will make way. Of course, this was the other way round against the Oval.
Number 15,
Beth
Katie
Mead
McCabe
is on in her place. Another opportunity for her to shine. And Louise Quinn
is number 23,
also makes way.
Beth Mead.
With Lisa Evans taking her place. So just a confirmation of those substitutions. Katie McCabe and Louise Quinn have left the pitch, with Lisa Evans wearing number 17 slotting into the back line, and Beth Mead joining the front line ensemble. First touch there for Lisa Evans. She sends the ball long. Ashlyn saying, come on, Mead. Yeah, she's certainly a fan's favourite, Beth Mead. Starting that goal in that game, in fact, at Yeovil. One goal for her. So far in this Women's Super League campaign. 19 or so minutes to go. Arsenal in control here, but won't want to take their foot off the gas, because they know West Ham United can punish them, as the ball is headed out by Leanne Kiernan. It's another throw-in. Ball just on that left-hand flank now, and Arsenal looking to work it in field. It's picked up by Little. Little smash it from range, and we'll find the back of the net. And May just have wrapped up the game for Arsenal. Captain fantastic Kim Little, a right-footed drive, beat Becky Spencer for pace, and Arsenal seem like they're on to another 3 points. Arsenal 4, West Ham United 2. Brilliant bit of play. And a fabulous drive from Kim Little. Arsenal completely 10, beat Kim Becky Little. Spencer for pace. The dip on the ball. Very, very good. And Arsenal's experience, their power, and their quality shines through. Arsenal leading West Ham United by 4-2 now. Esme de Graaf has joined proceedings. Leanne Kernan, who may have taken a slight knock, has headed down to the bench. She was walking slightly gingerly as she got up, recovering from a challenge. That is a strong challenge there from Claire Rafferty. A fabulous goal from Kim Little, making it 4-2 to Arsenal. Plenty of space. And Little punishing Becky Spencer in the West Ham United goal. But they've given a good account of themselves today, the Women's Super League debutants. It's all about consolidation. It's all about making sure they're in this league this time next season, as the ball is played in towards the near post. And Spencer just clawing it from the reaches of an Arsenal attacker. Arsenal now looking for a fifth. In towards Madema. She can't quite get a shot away. Nobbs takes a couple of touches and West Ham managed to regain composure and retain possession. Ball switches flanks now. Here's Van de Donk in towards the middle. Madema is there. Jordan Nobbs with the ball over the top. Nobbs will go for the second bite and just drags her shot wide. Nemi very, very happy with captain Kim Little. Absolute class is what Nemi says. Gary's got things on a dual screen mode. Thank you very much for joining us, Gary. Ashling says, beautiful work. We've got this game. Thank you very much for joining us once again. Arsenal just taking their time with this throw-in. Nobbs with a beautiful ball out wide for Van den Donk. Madema and Mead join proceedings. It's out wide now. In towards the middle by Lisa Evans. The ball just scooped up and picked up by Becky Spencer. But what a ball that was by Jordan Nobbs. Picked up well by Van den Donk, and the intelligence of her just to check onto the right. A quick breakaway for Arsenal. And not the best ball by Evans. Mitchell with the long ball forward. Nobbs gets a touch on it, doesn't know much about it. West Ham will bring it forward now themselves. And having been absolutely fantastic in the first half, West Ham United have been under the cosh somewhat in the second, with under 15 minutes to go here. Now Bournemouth. Pera Magnan just checks the ball forward. Arsenal with a patient build-up play. That's been the order of the day in the second half. And it's threaded through. Here is Vivian Madema onside. Madema for five. Fabulous save there by Spencer. Doesn't know much about it. Goes for the second, as does Madema. And it's deflected behind for the corner. Again, Jordan Nobbs with an excellent ball forward. Madema onside. Shoots towards the far corner. It's read well by Spencer. And the ball just up in the air. Mbeumo with the second touch, but Spencer with the second touch, and Arsenal have another corner. So we'll be captain Kim Little to take this one. It's swung in into the middle for Mbeumo with the header. She doesn't get any real contact with it. It's up into the air and cleared out for a throw-in. I think the best comment we've had on our stream today is from Chris Lambert, who said, "Who's having a bovril right now?" Love to be joining you, Chris. We really would love to be joining you. Getting into autumn, winter soon round the corner. Perfect condition to play in football, but it can be very, very cold indeed. We've had a question about one of the West Ham United players wearing gloves. No Arsenal players wearing gloves at the moment. They're too hot to handle for West Ham United, and a fabulous challenge there by Brianna Vassalli. Thrown by Rafferty, she'll send the ball down the line. Arsenal in total control. The fabulous ball played out wide, header on. Looking for the run of Mead or Kim Little. It's into the midfield and back with Little. Again, this is the control that the Arsenal manager Joe Montemurro looked for in his program notes. He talked about control. He talked about Arsenal needing to make sure they gripped onto this game before their opponents did. He knows West Ham United are organized, but his side have broken through and have a two-goal advantage on their visitors. It's won by Van der Donk. She takes a long-range shot, picked up and claimed by Spencer in the West Ham United goal. Thank you very much to everyone who's commented on our stream today, looking for more WSL action. There will be more live on Facebook next Sunday as Reading make the trip to Liverpool. We'll have that live from 2 o'clock. And it will be a fascinating tie. Liverpool haven't had the best of starts to their season, but have picked up 3 points today. Up against Kelly Chambers' Reading side, who have really been the surprise package of the WSL over the past 18 or so months. That one, a kickoff at 2 o'clock next Sunday. Do join us on Facebook. West Ham just trying to build an attack now. Jane Ross wants to go back to her goalkeeper. Sent wide left to Rafferty. Left footed ball scooped forward. And headed back by Williamson to her captain Little. Arsenal just sending this game into cruise control, making West Ham do the work as they send the ball around the back line. It's Williamson, she'll bring it over the halfway line. Well intercepted by Rafferty and into the midfield for Longhurst, whose presence on the game was somewhat diminished in the second period. Maybe suffering with a bit of a knock. Kate Longhurst with two great goals, two poacher's finishes in the opening 45. And West Ham United have a free kick now. Simic, the all action. Julius Simic will take this for the visitors. Right footed. Swung into the box. Headed away. strongly, and Arsenal will try and break with Jordan Nobbs, but that's well won in the midfield once again by Brianna Vassalli, who's been all action for the visitors this afternoon. Spencer will send it long. Not the greatest of kicks by the goalkeeper. Here is Evans, checks into the box. Lisa Evans sends it in, looking for the run of Maderma and Mead. It's back out wide for Beth Mead. Mitchell. It's picked up by Little in the midfield. Arsenal will regain a bit of composure. Forward for Van den Donk. Already has the hat-trick. On the overlap is Beth Mead at the byline. Mead still on the ball. Checks it back for Van den Donk. Left-footed ball. Scooped in. And McDermott can't get any purchase on the header. And it will roll out for the goal kick. Brilliant bit of work down that right-hand flank by Beth Mead. Checking onto one foot, then another, then back, and a couple of dummies before the back flick. And Van den Donk doing well to get some clear space to feed the ball in. McDermott with no real purchase on the header. Spencer with the ball forward. And West Ham United will look to break now. Vassalli gets into an advanced position. She's brought down. The linesman is flagging. And Paul Howard has awarded a free kick to the visitors in a very, very dangerous position. Julius Simic standing over this one. Claire Rafferty has taken over control. Rafferty with the short run up, looking to set West Ham away quickly. It is Rafferty with the ball in, and it's gone in. And we've got a grandstand finish here now. And Claire Rafferty grabs an unlikely goal. Poor from the goalkeeper, poor from Pauline Peyre-Magnan. And Rafferty with a short run-up fires the ball into the right into the heart of the Arsenal defence. And Lisa Evans and Pauline Peyre-Magnan just double-crossing each other. And West Ham United have won back. 4-3 now. And we really could have an exciting finish to this one. Arsenal with the throw-in now. Hev Osborne says, last minutes to get excited. Max is looking for Sari van Veenendaal to come back. Martin is talking about the goalkeeper as well, Pauline Peyre-Magnan, who hasn't been at her best today. Here is Longhurst, who's certainly got goal-scoring potential. She edges Kim Little off the ball. In fact, it's Lisa Evans she edges off the ball. And West Ham United win the throw, and I think Evans expected a free kick there, but it's the visitors who have possession. Ball scooped out to the far side. Percival on that right hand flank. Here is Percival once again. Drives the ball forward, looking for the run of Alicia Lehman. Not the best of passes, and Peyre-Magnan sends the ball forward. We're into the 87th minute here. And here come Arsenal now. Jordan Nobbs takes a shot. clatters the crossbar with the goalkeeper beaten. And Nobbs just reminding West Ham United that Arsenal still are the deadly Arsenal in attack. Ball squared by Evans, and Nobbs just took her time, dinked the perfect shot over. It rattled the crossbar. Spencer nowhere. And West Ham live to fight another battle in this game, which has really been end to end. A fabulous game of football in this Women's Super League. Here come Arsenal once again down the right hand side with Beth Mead. She'll go up against Rafferty. Mead continues, ball into the box looking for Nobbs. It will deflect away for the Arsenal throw, and Arsenal looking to kill this game off once and for all. They thought they had it won at 4-2, sitting in cruise control for 10 to 15 minutes of the game. But West Ham United with that late rally from Claire Rafferty, a goal which really should have been stopped by Pauline Pereira Magnan in the West Ham goal. But we certainly have a grandstand finish here. Little turns back and will head back into defence. Here is Leah Williamson. Ball in towards Nobbs, who tries one of those long raking passes forward. It's picked up by Spencer. And that's poor. Mead with the shot again. Spencer recovers. Poor by Brianna Vassalli, caught in possession. You don't want to let Arsenal catch you in possession. They will make you pay. West Ham United just looking for any opportunity to drive forward, looking to bring Alicia Lehmann into possession. It's still in play, the ball. No, it's just gone out. 30 seconds of the 90 remain. What's been a fabulous afternoon of football here at Meadow Park. Ball headed on by Lehmann. Awaiting the fourth official to find out how long we have left at the end of this half. The 3 minutes of added time allocated by the fourth official. And West Ham United have a throw-in and an opportunity to press Arsenal. It is down on the far side. Ball scoop up into the area. Looking for Longhurst, looking for Ross. It's picked up by Vassalli with the long range shot. And that just nestles onto the roof of the net with Pereira Magnin backpedaling. A dipping effort, which initially looked like it would be heading straight over the bar. But in the end, a very good opportunity for West Ham to gain parity once again. And ball surely there by Beth Mead. West Ham United with another opportunity here. They have an opportunity here through Rafferty, who will take one of her very much short run-up free kicks. Rafferty's going to look to send this in. She does. It's into the box. Headed on. Lehmann won't make it. Nobbs is there. Vassalli gets a touch on it, and it will be back with Rhea Percival, who sends the ball out. Van Donk keeps it in, but then concedes a throw-in. Maybe she ran into the ball there. The West Ham United manager just pushing everyone on the mat. Beard. We're into the final minute of added on time here at Meadow Park. Arsenal with the narrowest of leads. West Ham battling on. But here come Arsenal with McDermott. Mead making a run into the middle. McDermott still carries on. She'll head. You would think she'd head down towards the corner flag. Loses possession and retains it after some poor defending from Percival. Mitchell. And Little wins the throw in. We have played the 3 allocated minutes of added on time. And there we go. Full time at Meadow Park. Arsenal hang on for a hard fought victory against a very, very good West Ham United side, making their debut in the WSL. They didn't look like a team that had played a whole new, a whole different division of football last season. Arsenal really on the back foot for a lot of the of time. Longhurst with the opening goal for West Ham United. Van den Donk equalising 2 minutes later. Longhurst put West Ham back into the lead, and they took that lead through to just before half time as Daniel Van den Donk grabbed her second and Arsenal's second. Bloodworth with the opportunity. Dominique Bloodworth with the opportunity to put Arsenal back ahead as the half closed. The first half closed with a free kick that was fumbled. But then Arsenal pushed ahead with Van den Donk grabbing her third and Arsenal's third. Another hat-trick for Daniel Van den Donk, and it's 3 goals for her this season in the Women's Super League. Kim Little made it 4 with a rasping drive with around 20 minutes to go. But then Claire Rafferty, well, she caused a few issues for Arsenal and grabbed West Ham United's third to give us a grandstand finish. And we'll take a look at some of those goals and what has been a fabulous game here at Meadow Park. West Ham United just building up with a brilliant opener, some great work down the right-hand side, a better ball, and what a finish from Kate Longhurst, the striker's finish, and a glancing header to put West Ham United into the league. But it was set pieces that really undone Matt Beard's side. And a left-footed ball into the middle, and the ball just deflected past Rebecca Spencer in the West Ham United goal after Louise Quinn dropped the ball down from the air. Van den Donk with the last touch. But then some slack defending from Arsenal. With Pera Magnin not at her best, she parried that shot. And then Longhurst fired in for her second and West Ham second to give the Hammers the advantage once again. But going into half time, and it was Arsenal who were looking for that equaliser, desperately searching for it. And who was there again? Daniel Van den Donk giving Arsenal the second goal and an equaliser and an opportunity to start the second half on level terms. Arsenal grabbed their third. Sloppy again from a corner for West Ham United. Van den Donk with the hat-trick. And Arsenal's fourth, sheer class from their captain, Kim Little. Ball played into the middle, Little with a couple of touches and then a rasping drive right into the bottom corner. A fabulous goal from the Arsenal skipper. Then 5 or so minutes from time and we are treated to a very, very exciting finish. Claire Rafferty with a free kick that really should have been dealt with by a combination of Evans and Pera Magnin. But she gave us a grandstand finish. But West Ham United couldn't go on and grab an equaliser. Still playing in a few of the other WSL clashes across the country. We had full time, of course, earlier. Rinsola Babangida goal giving Liverpool 3 points. The Brighton and Hove Albion in the early kickoff. It finished here. Arsenal 4, West Ham United 3. They're still playing at Everton, where it's Everton 0, Chelsea 0. Manchester City 2, Bristol City winning 2. Bristol City 2 goals ahead there. And elsewhere, Adams Park is Reading 0, Birmingham City 1. We're back next Sunday, the 30th of September. Do join us for a 2 o'clock kickoff. It'll be Liverpool versus Reading. But we do thank you for joining us this afternoon on an afternoon where Arsenal have triumphed against West Ham United.
Still have the breakthrough. The angle brilliantly.
Manchester City leads.
Kirby onto a left foot, plants it brilliantly.
Oh, and it's in.
Oh, what a goal. To herald the fact that they are the champions.